I request Mr. Ajay Arora, Executive Director in Charge, Research and Development Center for Iron and Steel, Steel Authority of India, to kindly share a few words here.
Respected Dilip sir, my dear colleague Pankaj ji, Dr. Gautam, all the participants, my senior colleague from SAIL, ladies and gentlemen, Namaskar. Basically, as told my previous speaker, the basic concern of steel industries are environment, resources, manpower concerns, and also the challenge from the alternate material, similarly demand from the customer for weight reduction, and need for greater use of IT and automation. These are the basic concerns for the steel industry globally, and that's true for India also. Now, coming to our context, as told by previous speaker, we are producing more than 100 million ton of steel, and in the near future, the government policy indicates we are going to touch 300 million by the next decade, and that will be consumption of around 160 kg per capita from the current figure of 74 kg, whereas the global figure is more than 200 kg right now. So keeping this in view, the consumption in our country and other developing countries continue to grow. So the major factor is some sustainability indicators which are going to decide why we should go for innovation and improvement. And some of these key sustainability indicators are, first is greenhouse gas emission. International figures are hovering around 1800 to 200 kg of CO2. Whereas my company SAIL is hovering around 2300 to 2500 kg because I have a combination of old technology as well as new technology. Similarly, energy intensity worldwide is less than 5.5, whereas in my organization it is hovering between 5.8 to 6.5. Similarly, material efficiency is also percentage or two is lower than the international figures. And similarly, water consumption, environment, there are other figures also. I have taken only waters. So international less than 2.2 meter because they are using closed loop and other technology, whereas in SAIL it is around 3.5 meter cube per ton of crude steel. So these data on sustainability indicator clearly indicates that we should go for major improvements to catch up with benchmark figures. Though for achieving these figures and other technology parameter, the need for innovation is become all the more pressing. So basically, innovation is nothing but adapting to new means to achieve the modern time necessity to survive, grow, and sustain leadership edge. And to continue in this business, we have to innovate continuous basis. So innovation in our industrial context, I can divide in four areas. One, which we keep on doing is process innovations. That is how to improve my process on day-to-day basis. Then we are also aiming new products to meet our customer demands, as well as sometime we are also going for major invention or technological changes to fulfill those requirements. And overall, we should also go for a business model adoption to survive in the current scenario. So just touching on this, already someone has already given these figures. People are working to reduce the carbon dioxide emission, which is contributing around 8 to 9% globally. So there are various technology like CCS and others. SAIL is also working to substitute some of our coke makings with some non-coking methods. Already we are in discussion with GAIL, which are offering us a coal bed methane near Bokaro steel plant. And we are hopeful within a year or two, if coal bed methane is available at Bokaro or nearby area, we'll go for major injection blast furnaces as well as in the reheating furnace for the source of energy. Apart from this, we are also using our waste gas and recovering most of our waste gas value within the plant itself. Apart from this, our driver for innovation, one of major concerns is resources. SAIL is working from the last more than 60 years. We have a huge, I can say, dump or slimes available in the mines. We are putting lot of technology intervention there to recover those slimes and mines from the mines by using various combination of VAMPs, hydrocyclone, and other technology, magnetic separators, so that we can recover those slimes which are committed in the mines. Already, we have installed 1 million plant at near Bilai in one of the mines, and in other mines also, we are working on those things. Apart from this, we are finding some alternate method of using inferior Indian coking coal in our coke making for blast furnaces. For that, we are working, and we are finding we can go around 20% with the present quality of coking coal which is available to us from the Coal India. Apart from this, another innovation we are SAIL is working is IT and automation field, where we are using various data analytical tools to improve our product quality, less dependence on the manpower, as well as improving the our other IT-enabled services and e-commerce solutions. Also, we are working on automation in the risk-prone areas so that we can keep our employee healthy and safety of the employees in our topmost concern. Then, I have already touched techonomics and quality are one of the major tools for our innovations. Now, I will just give you some insight that SAIL is also having a very good interaction with our leading academia, that is IITs and other labs, so that we can get some help from them in solving our some technological problem which we are facing from the last so many years. So we have some MOU with them, and we are getting their assistance in solving our technological needs. And also, we are also getting their involvement in enhancing the knowledge of our working engineer as well as employees. In the recent past, SAIL R&D initiative has been in number of places in various plants. Some of these are, as I already told you, we are using around 20% of Indian coking coal. So we have developed, we have installed a new pilot coke oven having both wet quenching and dry quenching facility at Tranchi, where we can simulate what type of blend we can use, how to minimize our cost, as well as what heating parameter we have to keep in plants so that our blend cost comes down and our process improvement comes out of it. Similarly, we have installed pilot scale pelletizing facility at Ranchi, which will simulate various type of Indian iron ore which can be gainfully used for pellet making within our steel plants. And in beneficial iron ore and fines is a continued process which we are following very seriously. Apart from this, in our day-to-day plant improvement, we have taken a number of initiatives in improving our quality of feed, for example, sinter, iron making, and so on, where we have adopted very small, I will not say innovation, but small improvements, I can call it, like increasing the bulk density of raw mix, improve use of magnetic water, steam addition, so on, so that my sinter quality is improved, which will give me a lot of benefit in coke rate, as well as in productivity in blast furnaces. In iron making also, we have installed some combination of our ores, which will give me a better softening melting property so that my pressure drop in the cohesion comes down and overall blast performance improve to the DPR figures. Similarly, for road making, as someone has already told, we are also working to improve this quality of road LD slag by steam maturing so that this slag can be gainfully used for road making, as well as we are working along with some institute to bring down the chromium level in our LD slag so that it can be used as a slag, a soil modifier in the agriculture industries. Apart from this, as per our customer requirement, we are working on new products like nano steels, steel for strategic application, including defense, nuclear energy, and so on. Apart from, and also RDCIS SAIL is working on robotic laboratories at Ranchi, and we are also having some tie-up with Indian Oils, where we are working with nano coolant, which will help us for better cooling application in steel industries. Recently, SAIL has supplied some of the customer-made products to construction sector and also to rail, a rail LHP wheel. You might have heard it. SAIL, rail was importing LHP from abroad. SAIL has already supplied them 250 wheels so far, and our target is to supply 1,000 wheels by in this financial year. And once we get a customer feedback, then we'll be a regular supplier to LHP wheel to Indian Railways. Apart from this, we are supplying different type of product to different customer of the various industry, which have a high strength, high hardness, high wear property as per the customer requirement, both for auto industry and others industry. And some of the significant intervention by SAIL in the last year was supply of 2-pi grade steel to defense, non-microlide grade from RSP, then fire resistant steels. We are already in touch with Roorkee. We have successfully demonstrated We are getting a certificate from CBI Roorkee and so on. So in a nutshell, what we want to say, the innovation is a continued process. We have to follow it to remain competitive in the market. So we have to take care of both environment as well as business sustainability. And there is a greater need for a synergic approach of innovation involving industry and academic, as well as all the stakeholders. This is all I have to say. I also thank organizers for giving me a chance to share my thought with you. Thank you, everybody.